going on right now. South Florida, shocking Temple, 31-10 at the break. It's Houston trailing Memphis 20-7. That one just started up the second half. And LSU, they're also down 21-7 at the half to Arkansas. Moving over to the NBA, Clippers outlasted the Pistons 101-96. Blake Griffin tallied 34 points, and Jamal Crawford amassed 37. As always, go to NBCSportsRadio.com for a full check of all the scores, college football, NBA, and the NHL. Remember to listen to NBC Sports Radio on your local station, online, and the mobile app. I'm Keith Irizarry.
This is KCAA.
Here's all you need to know. There's a new cool way to sell your unwanted stuff online. It's buysellmakeoffer.com. Buysellmakeoffer.com. You're not going to believe it. Join the legions of web sellers and buyers who are turning to buysellmakeoffer.com today. Never pay fees again. For low monthly membership of $7.95, you can sell up to 50 items, and there's a 60-day free trial membership to get you started. You can even produce your own infomercial to sell your products and upload the video for the world to see. Go right now to buysellmakeoffer.com.
And now it's time for another Support San Bernardino Spotlight.
Hi, my name is George Hahn. I am the senior minister at the Center for Spiritual Living Inland Empire. In the next few weeks, we would like to support San Bernardino by highlighting the outstanding things about our city. Today's program features Michelle Takia. Please tell us about your involvement with the symphony.
Thank you, Reverend George. In the summer of 2008, I founded, established, and became artistic director of Symphonie Jeunesse Youth Orchestra for Strings. It was established for serious string instrumental students ages 12 to 18 wishing to advance their musical studies. Season 1 opened with 12 students, and over the next 7 seasons, the orchestra has grown to 35 members. We will be performing at Temple Emmanuel in Redlands on Tuesday, November 24th at 7 p.m. for the San Bernardino Clergy Association's annual Thanksgiving service. Symphonie Jeunesse holds auditions and is always looking for new members. Donations are welcome. Please call 951-203-0759. That's 951-203-0759. Thank you.
This program was underwritten by Center for Spiritual Living Inland Empire. If you would like information about today's program, please contact me, Reverend George, by calling 909-883-7171. That's 909-883-7171.
KCAA invites you to listen to professional money manager Bill Gunderson every weekday morning from 7 to 8 a.m. Bill Gunderson is a highly respected money manager. He's a regular contributor to MarketWatch, TheStreet.com, and Town Hall Finance. Gunderson has appeared many times on the Fox News Channel, the Fox Business Network, and CNBC. You can hear Bill Gunderson's daily insight into the market at 7 a.m. weekdays, right here on KCAA, the station that leaves no listener behind.
The Law Office of Brandon S. Chabner, serving clients in Southern California with transactional legal services since 2007. We handle general corporate, outside counsel type work, drafting and negotiating a wide variety of business and commercial contracts, including non-disclosure agreements, independent contractor agreements, and employment agreements. Our experience includes working with public and private companies and involves a broad range of industries, including healthcare, consumer products, real estate, and high technology. Mr. Chabner has over 20 years of legal experience, having worked for some larger national firms, and serving as general counsel for a multi-million dollar private company here in Southern California before starting his own legal practice. His educational credentials include a law degree from UCLA, where he was on law review, undergraduate degree at Yale, where he graduated magna cum laude, and an MBA from Harvard Business School. Other areas of focus for Chabner Law include press release and business plan editing, pre-litigation matters, and debt and mortgage resolution work. You can contact us at 310-698-0740. And at bchabner@chabnerlaw.com.
KCAA, where every day is a great day. KCAA, Loma Linda.
Good evening, people of faith. Thank you for tuning in to Switch Reels Gospel Hour. I am your host, Elisa. We are a diversified show that brings you not only God's Word, but the gospel music that will relax your body and mind. Also, we have guests that will give you something to remember.
I pray you'll be ours and watch us.
I pray we'll find your love.
I pray we'll find your love.
And hold it in our hearts.
And hold it in our hearts.
When stars go out each night.
Stars go out each night.
Remind us where you are.
Remind us where you are.
Let this be our. When shadows fill our day,
when shadows fill our day,
oh Lord, lead us to a place, oh man,
guide us with your grace,
guide us with your grace, give us faith so we'll be.
World. I am your host, Elisa, and you have reached Switch Reels Gospel Hour. And we have today Pastor Melvin Hagen from last week, and we're going to continue the subject of love, spiritual love, that is. And we have Reverend Ruth Libman as our guest in the studio. So hold on tight, and we'll be right back. Our call-in numbers is 1-888-909-1050. 1-888-909-1050. We'll be right back.
Old man Wrigley lived in that white house down the street where I grew up. Mama used to send me over with things. We struck a friendship up. Spent a few long summers out on his old porch swing. Was in the war, went in the Navy, lost his wife, lost his baby. Broke down and asked him one time, how you keep from going crazy? easy. He said, I'll see my wife and son in just a little while. I asked him what he meant. He looked at me and smiled, said, I raised my hand. Just what I can see, oh, I believe. A few years later, I was off at college, talking to Mom on the phone one night, getting all caught up on the gossip, the ins and outs of the small town life. She said, oh, by the way, son, old man Wrigley's died. Later on that night, I laid there thinking back. Thought about a couple long lost summers. I didn't know whether to cry or laugh. There was ever anybody deserved a ticket to the other side. It'd be that sweet old man who looked me in the eye, said, I raised my hands, bowed my head, finding more and more truth in the words written in red. They tell me that there's more to life than just what I can see. I can't quote the book, the chapter, or the verse. You can't tell me it all ends in a slow ride in a hearse. You know I'm more and more convinced the longer that I live. Yeah, this can't be, no, this can't be, no, this can't be all there is. Lord, I raise my hands, bow my head. Oh, I'm finding more and more truth in the words written in red. They tell me that there's more. Just what I can see, I believe. Oh, I believe. I believe.
Welcome back to Switch Reels Gospel Hour, ladies and gentlemen. We have in studio Pastor Melvin Hagan from last week. We were on the subject of spiritual love, and we're going to take off where we left off there. And we also have Reverend Ruth Lemon.
Good evening.
How are you?
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you. And good evening to you, Pastor Hagan.
Good evening.
Okay, so we're going to start with Ruth Lemon. She has some interesting stories to tell us about her battle with leukemia.
Well, I want to say one thing, not a battle. You know, last week when you called me, you told me that you were talking about love. And one of the things that I talk about in as I walked through the valley of joy of healing my body was love, because that was the first thing that I felt. I actually went to the doctor with a stomach ache, and they did a blood test on me, and within 20 minutes they had me in an ambulance. They took me to the hospital, and by the time I got there, my family was there. They took me in a room in the back, and they said, "You have less than 24 hours to live."
Oh,
and we have your family here with you because we knew that, you know, they should be here. And as soon as those words came out of his mouth, I looked at my children. I said, I didn't hear God say it.
That's right.
And I felt the shield of God covering my spirit, covering my body. And I looked at my doctor and I said, are you the doctor? Are you going to be my doctor? And he said, yes. I said, well, then I'm going to be fine, because between me, you, and God, all is well. And as I laid there, I was going in and out, but the thing that came to me is, you remember the lady who said, if I can just touch the hem of the garment, then I will be healed. And that was one of the scriptures that I held on to. And I know that if you have faith and you trust in God, then the healing is done. As a result of that, I was in the hospital for 42 days, and every day the doctor would come in and he'd say, Miss Lemon, how are you feeling? I said, I'm doing fine. How are you? One of the things that I did when I was in the hospital is I allowed myself to stay in the consciousness that God was healing my body. So I never allowed myself to go outside of that. And the tool that I used was meditation and prayer. And the prayer that I prayed was, as they gave me the medicine, is that my body only take in that which it needs, and that it does need, it doesn't take. And I would go into meditation as the medicine was going into my body, and I would visualize from my feet to the top of my head every vein, every blood cell, every platelet, every part of my body, and I would see it rebuilding and reforming new cells. And one of the things that I learned while I was laying there is that if we're trusting God and if we're having faith, then we have to look way beyond fear and know that God is taking care of everything.
That's right. That's Amen. Right. Wow, what a story. You know, it's interesting, ladies and gentlemen, because I actually met Reverend Lemon back in 2010.
That's right.
And she came to our fundraiser, which was a golf tournament, and we had a lovely time. It was a 3-day event.
Yep.
And on Sunday, the last day, we're sitting around the table having brunch, and the conversation came up, and just to show you how God works and putting things together, is that she, and this is the part you're not going to know about, but I praise God for you in my life.
Thank you.
Since then, I wish that he had brought you sooner. Come to find out that Reverend Lemon was a very good friend of my great aunt. So mind you, I have to say, I was blessed to have two grandmothers, a grandfather, two great aunts and uncles, multitude of cousins, all at the same time that I actually met. And Reverend Lemon actually was a good friend of my great aunt, which I had two of. So I thank God for you being in my life. And she doesn't know this part either, that after the golf tournament, she began to text me words of inspiration on a daily basis. I never even knew that she was going through trials of her own, but it helped me through whatever it was that I was going through. And I am so appreciative and thank you so very much.
You're welcome. You know, I started that as a sharing of the verses that I was using to heal my own self. And if you look and you read some of them, you'll see that even though it touched you that day, it was really about what I was feeling. But I always felt that I was blessed. I never had a fear. I never thought that I was going to die. I was never afraid of transition. And my thought was, if it is, then that's what God wants. Amen. Because you see, we've got to get beyond fear. I think that a lot of people who go through catastrophic illnesses make their transition because they're afraid. But I know that God created the hands of the doctors. Mm. I know that He created the medicine.
That's right.
And I know that He created somebody for it to come through.
Thank you.
And when we can allow that energy of God to work through us, if we can allow what He sends us. And so one lady asked me, she said, did you have chemotherapy? I said, of course I did. I had no choice. But the thing about it is that I didn't know it was chemotherapy. Because every time the nurse would come in the room, she'd say, Miss Lemon, we're going to start your medicine. Well, you got to know that when I was in there, the first 2 or 3 weeks, I didn't know what they were putting in my body. So by then it was already there. But I didn't worry about it. And so every day when they'd say, we're going to give you the medicine, I would say, well, okay. And I would read a book and meditate and know that God was blessing my body. I would say my prayer, close my eyes, and view the inside of my body being healed. And here I am today to talk about it. And I don't say that it's easy because, you know, sometimes fear is going to come because that's a human trait. We're going to get afraid. But within
right.
the fear, you got to know that God is all there is and that God is love.
That's correct.
And in loving God, you're loving that part of God that exists, that is you. You are that God is. And so I got past the fear. Every day, my goal was to stay in love and not in fear. Every day. And I believe that if we could talk in a more positive way when people are going through catastrophic illness and assure them that the peace and the love and all of the things that they're looking for are available, that many of them would probably experience the healing. Because how could Jesus do healing? And He didn't have the chemo, but He said, do you believe?
That's right.
And the Bible says, it is done unto you as you believe. So what are we thinking? What are we believing? You know, we're saying we're Christians, we're Buddhists, we're whatever we are. But what do we truly believe about this, whatever it is?
That's
you know,
right.
And I don't care what you call God, because everybody has their way. But at the end of the day, if you say you believe it, then why don't you trust it?
That's right.
And that's where the faith comes in. That's where you got to say, you know what? I don't care what it looks like. I know that God is healing my body right now. And the thing that gets me is just as I was coming in the parking lot, I asked for some directions and I told a lady, I said, listen, when you go home, turn the radio on because I'm going to be on talking about faith and love. And she said, and I told her, I said, I'm a cancer survivor. She says, well, good luck. It's not about luck.
Mm.
It's about faith.
That's right.
I trust God daily. I walk with God daily. And in doing that, I know that my body is healed. It's been 18 months. I had less than 24
Amen.
Hours. If you're looking, I want you to see me. And if you're listening, I want you to hear me. God will take care of you. Where is your faith? And what are you thinking about? Because it's very important that you understand that the healing power of God never stops. We stop. When we stop believing, when we can't believe that we, like that woman, can touch the hem of the garment, then we got something to think about.
That's right. And we also have to consider, and people have to know, that we as individuals each have a spirit within us.
That's right.
That causes intercessions between us and the Lord.
That's right.
And you ask and believe and you shall receive. We'll be back. We're going to a commercial. Stay tuned. Switch Reels Gospel Hour.
Thank you.
What have I learned so far? Well, I've learned there's no one right path for everyone. I've learned that without my high school diploma, I can only do so much. My options were limited, very limited. I found a free personalized learning program with Learn for Life that has a flexible schedule so I can keep my job while earning my high school diploma. I found a new career with training opportunities that would jumpstart my future. What have I learned so far? I've learned that I could change my life.
Are you 14 to 19 years old and looking for a free high school diploma program with flexible meeting times? This program allows you to keep your job or important family responsibilities while earning your high school diploma. If you've fallen behind on credits or dropped out of school completely, get back on track with free tutoring, a caring faculty, and one-on-one attention. For more information on how to reach your graduation goal, visit learnforlife.org. That's L-E-A-R-N, the number 4, L-I-F-E.org. Or enroll today by calling 877-360-LEARN. That's 877-360-LEARN.
Hey, this is Steve Sanchez, and do you know in 2007, I went off to the doctor for a basic checkup, and he informed me, Steve, you got plaque built up around your heart, and you're going to need stents. I informed him, with no offense, doc, I need a second opinion. I go off to a naturopathic doctor, and he introduces me to something called Zango. It's a juice made of the whole mangosteen fruit. You know, the mangosteen fruit has been used for centuries for healing. So, hey, what do I have to lose? I tried it. 3 months later, I go back to my cardiologist, no plaque, no stents, and I'm proud to say 7.5 years later, I'm stent free. I want to turn you on to Zango because it's the only true 100% mangosteen fruit juice. It's patented. In fact, the Mayo Clinic is paying attention because they're doing an extensive study because they cannot ignore all the testimonials around the world. I want to give you a free sample of the Zango juice today. Simply call 888-309-5656. That's 888-309-5656 for your free mangosteen juice sample today from the company called Zango.
You're listening to KCAA, your good neighbor along the way.
KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and your host, Elisa, bring you Switch Reels Gospel Hour. Thank you for tuning in.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Switch Reels Gospel Hour. We have in studio Pastor Melvin Hagen and Reverend Ruth Lemon. Reverend Ruth Lemon was talking about her success with leukemia. She said it was not a battle, so we're not going to use that word. But she's going to read out of Psalms 103, is it?
Psalms 103, where it says, Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. For who forgiveth all times iniquities, who healeth all of thy disease, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowns you with love, kindness, and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things so that your youth can be renewed and you can soar like eagles. And when I read that scripture, I realized I was soaring like an angel. I want to tell you that since I got the healing, since I got out of the hospital, 42 days in the hospital, and when I came home, I had to go back once a month for chemo. I didn't find out I was taking chemo until the second month I had got out because I never asked them what all the medicines were that I was taking because they had needles in me everywhere, right? Mm-hmm. So I went to a homecoming for one of my friends and I had to eulogize her. And while I was there, the pastor got up to talk and he talked about the fact that he had had chemo and he had had stem cell. And he talked about how chemo was poison. So I looked at my girlfriend, I said, is that what that's what they were giving me? Poison? She said, yeah. I said, you know, God was really answering my prayer. I said, because I never knew. He never allowed me to go through the fear, through the anxiety. And that was a blessing because I didn't attach myself to the situation. I only attached myself to the idea that I was whole, perfect, and well. And every day of my life, I declared it. When I got home, I created a vision board. And I found a picture of the most beautiful Ruth I had. Okay. And I put her in the center of that board. And I surrounded her with words that were the love of God. And I put healing all through it. When I go out and I talk to people in some of the lectures and some of the places that I go, I tell them, surround yourself with the healing power, the healing words that God has. Read it. Take it from where you can. Put it up so you see it every day. But that board is not only for the healing of the spiritual body, it's for the body, mind, and spirit.
That's right.
It's for where you work. It's for where you play. It's for the kind of people you attach to you, people that you meet. It teaches you to let go. You got to know when to let go of some things. Some people got to leave and some new ones got to come in. You might have to change the place you work because you no longer need to do that. You might have to change the streets that you walk down because you want to get out into nature. You want to see how creative God is. You know, I talk about when I look at the trees and I see a million leaves on those trees, and those trees stand there in faith, knowing every day that as the brown ones fall off, new ones are coming in. And when I would walk the street, I'd think about the blood cells in my body, and I'd say, as the old ones go away, the new ones are coming in. The body is recreating, that I'm becoming all things new, that I am that God is. And I talked and walked and did it every day because I knew that it was the truth. And sometimes we got to be willing to walk alone. So I didn't need anybody to walk with me. I didn't talk on the phone much. Some people got angry. Some people quit speaking to me. But what was there to talk about? I wasn't going to get on the phone and say negative stuff like, oh, I had chemo and today I'm not. I felt the crazy thing was every time I left out of chemo, I felt good. I didn't have the side effects. My bones didn't ache. My feet weren't swelling up. I wasn't having nausea. I was living in the idea that God had already healed my body. The thought that I would visualize me touching the hem of that garment, knowing that I was healed. I never had to doubt it. And even as I sit here now, I have no doubt that God sent me through that valley of joy so that I could come and give testimony to the healing work that still exists on the planet now. Not 5,000 years ago when Jesus did it, but right now, in this moment. And when we can start believing and knowing that these things are true, that they really occur, that God is real, then we will begin to see changes in everything. Because I tell you, when you pray and ask first, and then you go into the silence and you sit and you allow God to talk to you. You go into meditation. You say, I'm going to sit here and for 15, 20 minutes, I'm just going to sit with God. I'm not saying nothing. Amen. And you listen. And he will talk to you. He will talk to you to other people. He will talk to you through the nurses who came in and prayed with me. He will talk to the people who washed my body while I was in the hospital. And they would do anointing prayer on me. He would send you everything you need.
Amen. Let me ask you a question. Or let me, if I could, just for a moment. What would you say to my daughter? Because this is, I think God is always in everything, okay? Yeah. Who my daughter, who's been battling cancer now for about a little over 10 years. And right now she's going through chemo as we speak. Right, she lives in Georgia. Her name is Selena. Would you talk to her?
What I would say to Selena is let go and let God. As you're laying there, see that medicine going through your body, healing every part of your body, remembering that that was created out of the mind of God. And that as long as you're trusting him and releasing all of the past, forgiving yourself for everything that you ever thought that you did wrong, because in God there is no sin but a mistake, that he has forgiven you already, and know that you are healed simply because you can be, because you are that living demonstration of what God looks like when he says live every day. Live. And when you come out of the hospital, walk with God. Go out, take nature walks, spend time, say, you know what, God, what is it you want me to do? Because I know I have life in me. What is it you want me to do? Because all I thought about is when I get out of here, I got to tell people how wonderful God is. Because I know that healing nature exists. And don't be afraid. Don't talk to people who talk fear talk. Don't talk about what a bad thing it is. Talk about the wonderful valley that he sent you through so that you can get better. And if it's been going on for 10 years, let it all go. Live in this day. Don't think about the chemo you took 10 years ago. Think about what you're doing right here in this moment, this day. And when you come out of that chemotherapy, you live it like it's the first day of your life and you're starting new. And God has given you another road to travel and you never have to look back. Because I don't look back. I don't worry about the friends that dropped off because they said I wouldn't gossip with them and talk about my body being sick. I don't think about the people who didn't come and see me in the hospital because I knew that the people who were supposed to did. I don't worry about what I'm going to do when I get home because I know I will be directed. And since I've been home, my whole life has changed. My life was fantastic before, but it is amazing. Mm-hmm. I feel younger and better and newer than I've ever felt in my life. I feel like every cell in my body is whole. And if you close your eyes right now. I want you to close them right now with me, and we'll go into a visualization. We're going to start at the bottom of your feet, and we're going to see that healing power of God just working up through your body, through those veins. We see those cells materializing, red blood cells, white blood cells. We see the platelets tripling in numbers. We see it moving up through your legs, through your knees, through your thighs, through your lower stomach, through your abdomen, through your heart, through your lungs. And in the heart area, we see all of that love of God just surrounding you, blessing you, holding you. And we move it up into the area of the throat so that when you speak your word, you are saying, God healed me, that he loves me today, that I am his child. And when you come out of there, you have a testimony because your body responds to the word of God, and the words that I am speaking are the words of God. The words that you speak are the words of God. Learn to be still. Take time to meditate. Take time to sit with God and listen and see the things, hear the things that he has to tell you. Call forth those angels and guides so that they can be with you so that you never feel alone. Call forth your ancestors and tell them, I need every woman, every man in this family to just send that love to my body because I want to be here. I want to be that great and grand testimony. And know in this moment that God is healing you because that's all God knows how to do. That's all God does. Amen. And we're just going to bless it and say, amen, because amen. The Jesus work name. Is amen. Done. It's done. It's done unto you as you believe. Trust in the name of Jesus. Just trust. Because he sent him to teach us that we can heal. Do you believe it? Mm-hmm. What are you believing about yourself today?
Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
That was wonderful, Ruth.
Thank you.
Well, it's always good when someone gives a testimony because you never know who's out there who's needing help.
That's right.
Whose situation may be similar to the one that's being told. And like I said, we all need each other. I need you. You need me. We are just one big family.
That's right.
And that's the way God intended for it to be.
I want to say if anybody wants to talk to me, they want to ask me questions about how I felt, anything that you want to know about me, you can call right now. I'm an open book because that's why I'm here.
And that number is 1-888-909-1050. 1-888-909-1050. You are listening to Switch Reels Gospel Hour, and we have in studio Reverend Ruth Lemon and Pastor Melvin Hagen. So we're going to take a small break and come back to you in just 2 minutes and 2 seconds.
For more local radio every day,
Tune in to KCAA Loma Linda.
Wake up, business owners, nonprofits, and professionals. You already know that no one goes anywhere without their mobile device, so why isn't your business with them? Get a mobile app for your business from appsfor50.com. There's no setup fees or long-term commitment, and it includes a host of features your business can definitely benefit from, all for one low monthly cost. Let's face it, everyone's mobile. Sign up today, and we'll promote your business to 10,000 new local customers for free. Go to appsfor50.com. That's appsfor50.com.
And now it's time for another Support San Bernardino Spotlight.
Hi, my name is George Hahn. I am the senior minister at the Center for Spiritual Living Inland Empire. In the next few weeks, we would like to support San Bernardino by highlighting the outstanding things about our city. Today's program features Michelle Takia. Please tell us about your involvement with the symphony.
Thank you, Reverend George. In the summer of 2008, I founded, established, and became artistic director of Symphonie Jeunesse Youth Orchestra for Strings. It was established for serious string instrumental students ages 12 to 18 wishing to advance their musical studies. Season 1 opened with 12 students, and over the next 7 seasons, the orchestra has grown to 35 members. We will be performing at Temple Emmanuel in Redlands on Tuesday, November 24th at 7 p.m. for the San Bernardino Clergy Association's annual Thanksgiving service. Symphonie Jeunesse holds auditions and is always looking for new members. Donations are welcome. Please call 951-203-0759. That's 951-203-0759. Thank you.
This program was underwritten by Center for Spiritual Living Inland Empire. If you would like information about today's program, please contact me, Reverend George, by calling 909-883-7171. That's 909-883-7171.
Thank you for being a part of Switch Reels Gospel Hour on KCAA. Back to Elisa, your host.
Good evening, Gospel World. We're back with Pastor Hagen, Melvin Hagen, on the subject of spiritual love. How are you doing today?
I'm doing okay.
Well, that's very well, very well. And we also have Reverend Ruth Lemon, who's going to hang in here with us that's tonight. Right. Okay, Pastor Hagen, on the subject of spiritual love.
Praise the Lord. Saints, again, reading out of 1 Corinthians chapter 13, beginning in verse 4, just for a few moments. Charity suffered long and is kind, envieth not, charity vaunteth not itself, it is not puffed up. Doeth not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil. Rejoiced not in iniquity, but rejoiced in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Let us pray. Father, we thank you again. We praise you for another wonderful day. I thank you, Lord God, for testimony. I thank you for those that come across our path that love you, that put their trust and faith in you and in you alone. I also praise your holy name, Lord God, for divine intervention, that you step in the midst of things just because you love us, just because you're concerned about our well-being. So, Lord, I come to you now, Lord, and I ask that, through the power of your Holy Spirit that you would work with us today, work through us today. Let us see you, Lord, be that revealing God once again, that you might touch the hearts of those who truly, truly love you. And I pray for those, Lord God, that are listening even today, that does not know you as Savior, that through the power of your Holy Spirit, that you would even save them today. So, Lord God, we yield unto you, and we ask now that you have your way with us and do that which needs to be done. And Lord God, will give you all honor, all praise for what you do. You said, if we ask it, we shall receive it. So we even pray today in the name of Jesus. So, Lord God, have your way. That's my prayer. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.
I want to talk just for a moment because time is short. But we want to talk about the marks of love. And it's so important that we really understand what love really looks like. So often we give that lip service and we say to folks, I love you. However, love that doesn't produce anything, is it really love? That's my statement even to the church today. I say to you, if you say to me that you love me and I don't feel your love, is it really love? So it's important for us to really know about love and how it really is supposed to work in our lives or how it is marked in our lives. So the first thing that we see about love is that this love that we really and truly have, we call it an agape love. It's a love that has a prerogative. It can do whatever it wants to do. It can choose its objects. It doesn't have to be directed by anything. It just reaches out and grabs and say, I love you in spite of you. It doesn't even look at who you are, where you're at, or what your situations are in your life. It just says, I love. And I think that's a great picture of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who was in heaven with the Father and left heaven, walked the face of this earth for 33 years, gave up his life because, in fact, he loved us. He didn't look at us. He didn't examine us. He didn't see if we were fit to be loved. But he put his arms around us and loved us anyway. Amen? Amen. So it says, the Bible says that love or charity, it suffers long and it is kind. I think it's very understanding. I think that if we say that we love someone, if we're concerned about somebody, then we need to be kind. Kind. I think love without kindness is a bad thing. If you can't be kind, then you really can't love. It just goes together. But it also says that it's long suffering. So if you're loving someone in spite of them, you have got to be patient with that individual. Because there may not be a chance for that individual in your lifetime for them to turn around. But I'm telling you right now, regardless of what their situation is, if you just embrace them with love, God wants us to understand that his work cannot be done without love. So it's very imperative that we look at that and we understand that God is calling us to love. In the scriptures, in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32, God instructs us, and be kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven you. Man, that's awesome to me. We have that instruction that God says to us, that we are to be kind to one another, that we are to love one another. And again, we saw in Scripture in John, it talks about that God says that they will know that you belong to me by the love that you have one for another. So important for us that if we as believers, as those who really trusted the Lord Jesus Christ, can't love each other, man, it's a sad, sad world because we have got to love one another. And I'm talking about agape love. I'm not talking about some lustful love. I'm talking about agape love. We have got to just love each other unconditionally, just knowing and understand that we have made that choice. And we can only make that choice by virtue of the Holy Spirit. We have to have the Spirit of God. I was just talking to a lady a few moments ago. Now, the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God. If we are not a child of the Most High God, we're not impregnated with the Spirit, and we can't even understand these here things. Neither can we love. But if we really understand the love that Jesus Christ had for us, how he did come down, how he did walk the face, how he did die for us in spite of us, then that same Spirit that dwelt in the Lord Jesus Christ dwells in each and every one of us, and we can love as he did love us. Amen. Amen. And I think that that's beautiful for us to see God's calling us to love. But there's a negative tie that God wants us to see right here also. He says that love, it doesn't envy. Amen?
Amen.
Love does not envy, but seems the fact that we're always envying somebody else. I like that coat. I wish I had that coat. Or why does God give to so-and-so and won't give to me? We're always trying to look. God's love is perfect, it is complete, and it is content.
Amen.
Happy right where it's at.
That's right.
And it's so beautiful to understand. I think that God, my God is so good, boy. But he can deal with an individual on the lowest level and satisfy that individual on the lowest level, and can also deal with an individual that's upstanding and with the multitude. So we need to know that that's God. That's how our God works. There's no envy in God. One does not say one to the other that I want what you have, or I needed. Why didn't God give that to me? Or why didn't God make a way for me? How come I can't be? Or how come she is? Doesn't envy. God said it doesn't envy. So we should not allow envy to be a part of our life.
Amen.
God understands that there's inequalities on earth, and knowing that love is happy all by itself. Amen.
Amen.
So let me move on, because I got to hurry up, because I got one more thing. See, the Bible says that love also vaunteth not itself. God says that in the Word of God, that love does not lift up itself. It doesn't promote itself. It doesn't parade itself. So many. I just think about this scripture in Luke chapter 18. And God talks about these two people that went to the temple to pray. And one of them happened to be this here Pharisee. And this here Pharisee was such a wonderful Christian. I mean, he started talking to God and started speaking to God about how great he was. Oh, God, how great am I? And a lot of times we get that way because we're doing things for God. And a lot of times this pride, which God really calls it to be wicked, this pride takes over because we think that we are doing. And that's what's so bad about us. God wants us to do good works and glorify his name. We do it for the glory of God and not for oneself. But often, love, and I tell you, if we just love and have that love of God, it doesn't parade itself around. It does not vault itself up. It's not a boaster. It's one that gives credit to the Lord Jesus Christ for what he has done for us. I thank God. I just thank God today for my salvation. I thank God today for Jesus Christ loving me. I never thought about doing the will of God. I just do the will of God because I believe what God has said. I believe what God has done for me. So just in my trust and faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, as he works in my life, and this here love, this agape love, is transformed right through my body. It's transformed to every object that I choose to love. And I choose to love everybody. There's no one excluded. My worst enemy, I still find myself wanting to love, wanting to share the gospel of Christ with that individual, that that individual might receive the things of God. Amen.
Amen. Well, gospel world, we're at the edge of our minute, and we will be back next weekend, Saturday at 6 o'clock, 6 to 7 p.m., Switch Reels Gospel Hour. And we're calling from Kcaa, 1050 AM, the station that leaves no listener behind. Thank you. And we'll see you next week. Tune in, 6 o'clock PM. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wake up, business owners, nonprofits, and professionals. You already know that no one goes anywhere without their mobile device, so why isn't your business with them? Get a mobile app for your business from appsfor50.com. There's no setup fees or long-term commitment, and it includes a host of features your business can definitely benefit from, all for one low monthly cost. Let's face it, everyone's mobile. Sign up today, and we'll promote your business to 10,000 new local customers for free. Go to appsfor50.com. That's appsfor50.com.
Kcaa invites you to listen to professional money manager Bill Gunderson every weekday morning from 7 to 8 a.m. Bill Gunderson is a highly respected money manager. He's a regular contributor to MarketWatch, TheStreet.com, and Town Hall Finance. Gunderson has appeared many times on the Fox News Channel, the Fox Business Network, and CNBC. You can hear Bill Gunderson's daily insight into the market at 7 a.m. weekdays, right here on Kcaa, the station that leaves no listener behind.
Wake up, business owners, nonprofits, and professionals. You already know that no one goes anywhere without their mobile device, so why isn't your business with them? Get a mobile app for your business from appsfor50.com. There's no setup fees or long-term commitment, and it includes a host of features your business can definitely benefit from, all for one low monthly cost. Let's face it, everyone's mobile. Sign up today, and we'll promote your business to 10,000 new local customers for free. Go to appsfor50.com. That's appsfor50.com.
This is 1050 AM, KCAA, Loma Linda, and 106.5 FM, Yucaipa.
So, you've moved, and you've got a lot of things you don't need anymore. Where are you going to turn? Nope, not them. But a new, cool, and innovative way to sell your unwanted stuff online, waiting for you at buysellmakeoffer.com. BuySellMakeOffer is exactly what you do. There are positively no fees whatsoever, but there are four different monthly memberships to choose from. Skype is available with each. So cool.
Yep.
And there's a 60-day free trial membership to launch your very own store online. BuySellMakeOffer.com could be the next big thing.
Oh, yeah.
Good news is it's already here. Sign up today. Go to BuySellMakeOffer.com right now and see what the buzz is all about.
Empire Talks Back.
The attitude that, well, the little guy cannot win seems to...